It's normal in the West that when a religious group seeks recognition, that there is an investigation which can involve different agencies, including the political branch of the police in the countries where it exists, or the intelligence service. But the difference is that all these institutions in the West are under democratic control. So they are ultimately controlled by parliaments and by democratically elected governments. So if these institutions do something against the freedom of the citizens, there are a number of recourses in a democratic system. Of course, all this doesn't exist in mainland China, which is not a democratic country. So the problem in Hong Kong is under British rule, of course, there was a certain system in place, but this system was part of British law. So you have to imagine the balance of justice. On the one hand, there were some systems of control, but on the other hand, under British law, it was in British rule, it was possible to appeal in case of misuse of the system to democratically elected authorities. Under Chinese rule, things are a little bit different. And so, again, I believe that beyond the strictly legal problems, I'm not competent to comment about what really the articles say, translated into plain words, is that organizations the CCP does not approve of should not be registered in Hong Kong. And again, there is a misunderstanding about cults. Because here cults presumably translate CGIAO, and CGIAO in mainland China are religious groups the government does not approve of. And in no countries in the West there are laws distinguishing between religions and cults, because this distinction is impossible. There are some laws I do not particularly agree with in countries such as France, which incriminates religious groups using what they call the mental manipulation. I do not agree with these laws. I believe they are bad laws, but yet they do not use the word cults. And they do not establish that good religions can be registered and bad cults cannot be registered. At the end of the day, I believe that the standard in a democratic system is always behavior. It cannot be belief. Of course, I would agree if somebody will tell me that in Hong Kong or anywhere else, a religious group cannot be recognized as such or registered if they have a consistent partner of criminal activities. But these criminal activities should be proved. And in the case of the Church of Almighty God, we have a constellation of rumors, fake news, dubious news, and this evidence doesn't seem to me to be very strong or perhaps to exist at all. The Church of Almighty God is clearly a religious organization. So if Hong Kong laws allows bona fide religious organizations to be registered as charities, then the Church of Almighty God qualifies because it's a religious organization.